I had to add this in. My camera didn't work the whole time, so I have put some video in there so you can see some stuff while I jibber jabber and tell you all this cool stuff. So bear with me, be patient with me, and it starts right now. Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I had a blast this week. I got to see so many vendors and watch different stuff. And if you're on my email list, you already know some of this because I shared it with you, but I haven't shared what I learned. I just kind of hinted around at what I'd been doing. Traveled all the way to New York, went to Cleveland, Ohio, went to Fort Wayne, Indiana, then all the way down to Georgia, and met vendors. I got to hang out with Michael Wood at the Boss Hog barbecue cook-off and had a blast. And got to meet some one vendor there from our Vendors United group, vendorsunited.com. Wink, wink, hint, hint. Who has gone from a big dog cart to a sexy, sexy stand-in trailer. I'm talking, I don't think I've been in a prettier trailer inside of one. They did themselves. It is fantastic. It is gorgeous. It is clean. But then I was walking around this event with Tasha, and I got to noticing there's a line at this one vendor, and I walked over there to it, and it's an old, old, old Coca-Cola trailer that they pulled behind a truck, and it opens up on three sides and then a back door. So it opens up, you know, like wings, open up the sides, the front, and it is a funnel cake and corn dog vendor. And I got to meet that feller, and he spent a lot of time with me, and he promised me he will come on here live and share what all he does. But a super, super, his deep fryer in that trailer is 15 years old and looks brand new because he keeps it clean. And so anybody walking up and sees something nasty makes them question the food. He keeps everything so clean and everything so nice. And they were selling these tornado potatoes. Okay, it's like a spiral cut potato on a stick, deep fried. And then they had corn dogs, best corn dog I've ever eaten in my life. I don't know, but I'm going to ask him where he gets his batter because it's super, super thin and crispy. So not a big bready, yucky, freaking state fair corn dog. Okay, I don't like those. You might, and I'm okay with that, okay? But I got to see him operate with his... with everything he was doing, and then I got to watch vendors do lemonade, and I got to watch vendors do barbecue, and you start picking up, and you start looking around, you're scanning, and there's probably 60 vendors in this field, in a circle, like a semicircle, kind of an oval, and I'm watching them, and some of them have lines, and some of them don't, and you go, well, why don't they have lines? They're serving, most of them are serving barbecue, because that was the competition. So why are the ones that have barbecue, why some have lines and some don't? Cleanliness. So I got to looking at that and started looking at their signage and looking at everything, kind of the stuff I do when I do a private consult or we help a vendor out in Vendors United and they're telling us, hey, I'm struggling here. You know, I can't get over $300 a day. I can't figure out how to break that. I hit 280 and then I'll do 300 and then I'll do 220. And how do I get over 300 a day? How do I get to 500 and 600 a day? How do I get to 1,000 a day? So it all comes down to typically food, menu, presentation, and your setup. If your setup ain't clean, people don't want to come to it, especially women. Okay, it's why female vendors do so much better than a male vendor. Okay, and it doesn't mean a male vendor can't make a ton of money. I was there with Michael Wood, who had been in the business for over a decade, and then the master of ceremonies there, the Boss Hog, in his white suit, like Boss Hog, is begging him to open back up for the city because it helped the city. Okay, and so I'm looking at all this stuff, and it's all because typically vendors who I guess don't have a clean setup. Let me give you an example. And I'm going to share these pictures later. If you're on my email, you'll get them. If you wonder how to get on my email, just go to learnhotdogs.com and a box will pop up. Just sign up. You can always delete it. You won't get bombarded, but I'm going to send you emails. But it's all good information if you're looking to get into this business. It'll save you a bunch of crap with learning curves and all that stuff. So you'll be able to skip to the chase. But if you'll go over there and sign up, I'm going to be sending pictures of some of these setups. Well, one of them we walked up to because Tasha wanted street corn. And this vendor had a corn roaster that was beautiful. I took pictures. Going to share it in the email. Gorgeous corn roaster, right? And it pulled behind his truck and everything. It's just nice. Nice, clean corn roaster. His table, though, okay, looked like somebody who didn't know about bacteria and didn't realize that when you set up mayonnaise, real mayonnaise, you need to have it in an ice bath or with ice packs underneath it or something. We're in 90 degree heat. He's out there with mayonnaise that he puts on a street corn sitting on the table in the hot sun. So every time he opened the lid, it kind of squirted some because of pressure. So it just yuck. Well, nobody wanted it, so we just walked off, okay? And I'm not beating him up. It's stuff that people should know, but it's what the type of stuff we teach. So he could have made more money, and he never had a line. The whole time I was there, several hours, never did he have a line. He'd have a person walk up, get a corn, and walk off, but I never saw a line. Then the vendors that are the cleanest, lines, 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 lines. The ones that wore gloves and looked like they cared about your safety and giving you the best product, those were the ones that were doing the best. Even though all this competition wasn't competition anymore. It's kind of why the vendor, it's called the Gen X cart, and they have a two daughters in the Air Force, and their third daughter's fixing to go to the Air Force when she graduates this year. Just an amazing couple. They're in our Vendors United group, and I took videos, and I'm going to share all that with you, but they had a gorgeous stand, a pull-behind, walk-in-to stand they had built out that was clean, clean, clean. I'm talking clean, clean, clean. Inside and out, everything was perfectly placed, so if somebody walked up to their back door, you could see, these people care about the stuff they're doing. These people are clean. And it's kind of like if you've ever been to a restaurant and you go, I wonder what the kitchen looks like. If you ever walk into a kitchen in a restaurant, you'll probably be gagged out and won't ever go back. A lot of restaurants, they kind of keep them crappy. And then there's restaurants that don't. There's restaurants that take pride that the back end looks cleaner than the front end, where you're sitting. So it's one of those deals. And so as you're walking around, a lot of times you're cutting between trailers and stuff and food stands, and you get to see inside the back door. And you're like, what the crap? It looks like those French fries on the floor have been there 9 weeks with mold growing off of them. I'm talking ick you out. Ick you out. So, If you decide to do the business or you're already in business, I promise you, you will increase your business just by being cleaner, just by showing off, okay? Now, I will tell you this. Hot dog carts, you can do street corn on, you can do pasta on, you can do potatoes on, you can do all the stuff if your state allows it. But my point is it's open and it's nostalgic. But the beauty is they get to see your front end and your back end because it's all around and in front of them. So with a hot dog cart, it is so easy to walk up to and see it just how clean you keep it. And it's why it's critical that you take pride in your cart. If you saw Michael Wood, his cart, when he sold it, it was 12 years after he bought it, looked brand spanking new. Did that take work and effort? Abso-freaking-lutely. His cart looks better than mine, and I keep mine clean. But it looked like it rolled out of the factory door that minute. Why? Because he took so much time and patience in keeping everything pristine. It meant he made more money, okay? He's from a small town in Georgia. I filmed him on here. You can watch him on here. In fact, we have a day in the life of him, which is a video series. You get to see him from packing up to setting up to tearing down, serving customers, tearing down, cleaning up, and going home. You get to see the whole thing, okay? So you can find that at learnhotdogs.com too. So I think it's learnhotdogs.com/best day or best day ever. It's one of those, okay? Anyway, I want to show you something, though. Barbie is a vendor that the last time she emailed me before just recently was in 2020. And she's going, Ben, I have a wedding reception. What do I do? COVID, blah, blah, blah. And I told her what to do. And so she did it. And here's where I said what to do. And then she did it. And she says, thanks so much. I appreciate it. Well, she then sent me a video. Okay, a video of her whole setup and what she did. And I want to share that with you real quick and let you watch that. This is her setup during COVID. Not that, that we're out of COVID, but do you see how she's done her spicy mustard, her mustard, her ketchup? Everything's in individual serving containers. They're called portion control containers. And then she's got everything individually wrapped already. They're in masks and stuff. This is the height of COVID. And she's just does a walk around of her cart. Now I want to show something to you. This is now, okay? She just sent me this. She said, Ben, exclamation marks. After following your guidance and advice for 4 years now, business is better than ever. Things are so good. My husband and I just put in our order for a Stand King. Another cart we sell, but it's an enclosed cart. So it's a Stand King. It's like a hot dog cart inside of a trailer, right? We are beyond excited and can't wait to pick it up. Also, as a Vendors United and Mafia member now, we when and where do I watch the info on live streams and announcements? I answered it later. I don't want to miss out on any benefits of being a Mafia member. Will I get a chance to meet you when I pick up the trailer? Thanks so much. Hot Dog Mama, Barbie Chandler, Lebanon, Tennessee. So I just wanted to share that with you so that you know that there's thousands of vendors, okay, that contact me daily. I get hundreds of emails daily of stuff like this. And I'll start sharing more of that with you, but I always email them out. I try to always email them out, and I definitely share them in our Vendors United group. And if there's tips and tricks and anything that someone can learn from, I share it. So I just wanted to come today and tell you, if you are thinking about the business, I promise you, you can join Vendors United absolutely free, okay? Absolutely free. And try it out. You can test drive it. You can have access to every file, every secret, every tip and trick, everything. Just download it all. And then you could leave. Otherwise, you could stay in and go, you know what? I love this. I'm gonna go from A to B without having to do a zigzag pattern to it and get to where I need to be. So the bottom line is if you'll join us and you want to be successful, I'll guarantee you, you will be successful, period. If you do the steps that I teach, you will be successful, period. There is no ifs, ands, and buts. It doesn't matter if you're in the smallest town. In fact, if I go VIN now, I'm going to go to a small town. I do better. And if I'm in a big city, I'm going to go on the outskirts because I always do better. In the suburbs, I do better out in the rural areas. And it's because of the nostalgia of hot dog vending. There's so many benefits to it, and you can make a lot of money. You don't have to call your boss tonight and tell him, kiss your butt. What's that old song? Take this job and shove it. You don't have to do that. I had a preacher, just here's a side note. This is because I am who I am. I have a preacher. He's a buddy of mine. His name's Billy Gower, and he was the lead guitarist, and he did bass too, bass guitar, for the guy that sang that song that became popular. And I don't know if you know that song, but you can look it up. If you're my age, you definitely know the song. But it's called Take This Job and Shove It. And he toured with him, and he was in that band. And now he's a preacher in Kentucky, little hillbilly redneck preacher. Anyway, you can take anybody can go anywhere with a cart and make money. You don't have to quit your job. You can go, hey, I'm going to do this 2 times a month. And here's what's going to happen. If you follow my steps, you will make more 2 to 3 days a month than your income provides now. If y'all remember when I shared back in 2009, a doctor came to me. He had lost his practice because he had opened up multiple practices and multiple businesses around Charlotte. And he pulls up in one of these Mercedes SUVs, and he buys his first hot dog cart from me. And now that's what he does full time. He never went back to being a doctor, okay? He's still a doctor, I guess, but he ain't doing it, right? He's doctoring hot dogs, and he's serving them to people, and he's got multiple carts now he's bought from me, and that's what he does. Why? Less time, less headaches, less stress, all doing vending. So you can test me on this. That's the beauty of this. It's a fail-proof business. Test it out. If you don't like it, you go, gosh, dang it. I don't like these short hours and big pay. I hate it. I don't like it. Then you can just quit and go back to Walmart or go back to truck driving or go back to whatever. Doesn't matter. Nobody's going to say anything. I'm glad there's people that work at McDonald's. I've said this before. Because when I pull up, I don't want to have to climb through the drive-thru window and make my own damn sandwich. I like the fact that somebody's working there. So I'm always happy that there's people that find their niche and they like that job. I don't. I have a family member that's been at McDonald's over 25 years. She's a manager in Sevierville, Tennessee, a manager of a McDonald's, one of the busiest McDonald's in the state. Okay? And I think it's $1 million a day they do, roughly. Okay? And she manages that. And I go, I'm thankful that there's people like her that will do that because I don't want to do that. I like working less, fishing more. So I love you. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you back real soon. I'm going to be bringing you two more videos this week. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.